This is a copyrighted work. Unauthorized copying or distribution is a crime punishable by up to 5 years in prison and a fine of $250,000.
Scholastic Audio presents In the Spirit of a Dream, 13 Stories of American Immigrants of Color, developed by Alina Chow, written by Aida Salazar, illustrated by Alina Chow, Bianca Diaz, Dion MBD, Famida Azim, Gabi D'Alessandro, Jose Ramirez, Ken Daly, Nicole Hsu, Paolo D. Campos, Rehele Jomepor Bell, Tracy Guito, Vanessa Flores, and Yaz Imamura. Narrated by Robin Miles. When you hear this sound, it's time to turn the page. In the Spirit of a Dream, illustrated by Alina Chow. We set out across continents, oceans, and borders to find a place where we have been told our dreams can be made, the United States of America. We come as migrants, often unwanted, to this country that will always belong to the First Nations to inhabit it, was built largely by those enslaved and forced here, together with those who are immigrants like us. We follow a dream that doesn't always come true. Sometimes it fades before us, yet we persist and pursue it to awaken a future of our own. These are some of our stories, the songs of our spirits, our longings, the challenges, and the heights to which we have risen in search of fulfilling our wildest imaginations. Alejandro Albor, Paralympic hand cyclist. Illustrated by Bianca Diaz. At 15, Alejandro came to the United States from Mexico with his family to labor as farm workers. A dreamer driven to fit in, to learn English, to rise and be a pro boxer one day. Not soon after, his bright life was nearly extinguished when the car he was driving collided with an oncoming train. He survived the wreckage without the use of both his legs. As his body healed, the sun of hope began to shine, illuminating new ideas and abilities. Alejandro propelled himself into hand cycling. With each pedal and stroke of his three-wheeled machine, moved by the strength of his arms and the determination to do something great, he became a Paralympic athlete. The skill and radiance of his racing pushed hard against any wind, leading him to win 2 Olympic medals for the U.S., ultimate symbols of a dream. Anusha Ansari, astronaut. Illustrated by Rehele Jomepor Bell. With her little feet planted on Iranian soil, Anusha wished to be an astronaut, to fly into space and soar among the stars. But the Iranian Revolution came, and the horrors of that war tried to wipe those dreams away until she came to the United States. Here, the many languages that surrounded her flew into her ears and stayed: English, French, and Russian. She never forgot the beloved Persian sounds of her birthplace. The languages of math, science, engineering became her strength, her ticket to become the first female private space explorer and the first astronaut of Iranian descent to float among the stars. Ayub Khan Omaya, surgeon and inventor. Illustrated by Nicole Shu. A renaissance coursed through Ayub's veins, a limitless bounty of what he could do. He excelled with bravado as he swam into a national championship, boxed with skill for rounds in the ring, and rode for miles along a river. He invented things that only an imagination so free could bring, like an airbag helmet to help protect people when they fall. He sang operas with gusto before performing surgeries, a musical rush helping him save countless lives, like those of the man from whose head he pulled a tendril-like tumor in an operation lasting 19 hours. Ayub and his light came from Pakistan. He made history in the United States and beyond with his inventive dreams, his unstoppable courage, and his love of life. Cándido Camero, percussionist. Illustrated by Ken Daly. Cándido was a virtuoso percussionist when he left Cuba for New York City in the 1940s with nothing but the dream to share the magic of his music with the world. A conga drummer whose Afro-Cuban blood lined the perfect rhythms that he played, Cándido was one of the first to bring these sounds to jazz. Cándido's dream rose like an incantation. He played with the most famous jazz orchestras around the country. His drumming popped out of crackly radio speakers, clubs, and dance halls alike. He spellbound with his innovation, played three congas when others played one, added a gyro and bell when others never imagined. He tuned his conga drums to play a melody, to create a sweet and rhythmic tune. But he endured segregation and racism because he was black in his new country. He often had to sleep on the tour bus because whites-only hotels didn't allow him to stay, or enter through back doors of whites-only clubs where he was the featured performer.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.